Never in recent history has back to school generated this much attention and controversy, not even in the swine flu pandemic of 2009. The public schools are opening back up, more gradually in some districts than others. While our state has been heading in a good direction this month, it is hard to say where we'll head next. We know children can handle this virus better than adults based on the current numbers. Pediatricians believe kids face more danger from flu than COVID. But that is not the whole picture. There are still important questions about what happens to the broader community when schools reopen. Exposure to the coronavirus could force students and staffers to quarantine and get tested. Large outbreaks could require closures, sending them online for a few days or longer. And our first look at how that might work. The Woodlawn School District, it didn't reopen as planned this morning. Education Commissioner Johnny Key says someone who works in the cafeteria tested positive and had six close contacts. TGP11's Mercedes McKay spoke with parents about how they felt hearing the news only hours before campus reopened.
At 10 p.m. last night, the school district posted on their high school's Facebook page and website for parents to not bring their children to school until further notice so staff can receive COVID-19 testing. This sudden change brought mixed emotions with the parents I spoke to.
I read a post from a teacher saying Woodlawn's not having school, and I'm like, are you serious?
Tori Jallo woke up this morning and got her kids ready for what she thought was going to be their first day of school.
I would have never known until I drove over there. They should at least, called somebody or sent a letter or something.
Jallo got confirmation after calling a teacher that she wouldn't be able to send her 5-year-old son Hollis and her 3-year-old son Cersei to school hours before she was ready to hit the road.
Hollis goes, that's not fair. They should have done that already. That's not fair.
Jallo says she's glad they caught it before she sent her kids inside, but she's confused about the guidelines.
I just think that if it is the regulations, for them to all the teachers to get tested and stuff before school started, it should have already been done.
A parent of a high school senior and kindergartner, Marty Reed, says he heard about the delay Sunday night, but it wasn't a shock to him.
We've all pretty much come to anticipate this problem coming up at some point, so I was not that surprised. I was a little surprised that it happened as quickly as it did.
He says hearing the announcement left him with gratefulness for the district he trusts his children with.
The right decision's not always the easy decision to make. So I think they made a call that they felt like was in the best interest of the students and the staff.
Both Jallo and Reed agreed this doesn't give them any hesitations for when the time comes to send their kids back to the classroom.
This pandemic is something that we're all going to have to deal with at some point. It's not going to go away. We just have to learn how to adjust and how to deal with it as it comes our way.
In Ryson, Mercedes McKay, THV 11 News.
Well, the district hopes to start school this Wednesday, and we're going to be following that. And we have much more for you on the return to school in just a few minutes.